Now, the next SEO tip I'd like to talk about are basically explaining follow and nofollow links. Now, by default, if you, for instance, insert a link into your website, it'll be what's called a follow link. So, you know, when you just insert a link that says, you know, click here to see maybe another page or maybe click here to view another website, by default, they would be follow links. Now, what the follow means is that obviously with any link that you create, users, you know, people can click on that link and basically follow the link. That's no problem. However, if you specify the link as a nofollow link, people can still follow that link, but the search engines will not follow the link. In actual fact, they may in some cases follow the link, but more specifically, they won't transfer any link juice or page rank value from one link to another. Now, when you have a website, one of the first things you start learning about if you're serious about your SEO is that you want lots and lots of really good links to your website from other websites, and also that these links should be relevant to your website and they should be from high quality websites. Now, in many cases, it's quite easy to get links from other places to your website, but what you may not realize is that these links will be nofollow links. So, for instance, let's say you've got a website and you create, say, a YouTube channel, and you then go and put links from your YouTube channel to your website, then these will be nofollow links. So the links will still work for people, you know, for humans, but any sort of goodness, any link value associated with YouTube as such will not be passed directly to your website. So that's really what nofollow means. It means don't sort of transfer goodness from the original website to your website or from your website to somewhere else. Or more specifically, things like PageRank will not be affected by nofollow links. Now, as far as your website's concerned, there's really two types of nofollow attributes. This is actually a page from Google. And if we come down here a bit, you can see here, this is a meta tag that you can put into your page header. And what this basically says to the robots is don't follow. And this works at a page level. So let's say you had a page on your website and for one reason or another, you were quite happy for people to go to that page, click on the links and go someplace else to view information, but you didn't want Google to follow the links to somewhere else. Maybe they might be slightly dodgy links in some way as far as Google's concerned. Or they might be links to unrelated pages, which again might confuse Google. So if you do have a page that's kind of full of links and you don't want Google to essentially follow those links, as I say, what you do is you put this line here into the head area of that particular page. And say this works at a page level. Now, as you can see in the headline here, you can use what's called rel equals nofollow for specific links. So let's say you had half a dozen links on your page and you wanted, for sake of argument, three of them to be follow and three of them to be nofollow. Then by default, they'd all be follow links. So what you could do is insert this little piece of code as an extra attribute to the link coding. And you might think, whoa, that sounds far too complicated. Well, for those of you lucky enough to use WordPress, as you probably notice in WordPress, if you want to do something, the answer of how to do something is always the same. Install a plugin. That's why I love WordPress. So let's say you're not happy with actually manually going in and editing the code, then what you can do in WordPress is install a nofollow link plugin. Let's actually do this. Now here I am in WordPress. What I'm going to do is I'm going to type in something like see my computer training materials website, something like that. And if I just simply select that, go up here, enter the address of the website and just confirm that. There we are, we've got a link. And I'm going to update this. And I'll view the page. And if I go and click on that link, as you can see, it works absolutely fine. I can use the back button to go back where I was. Now, by default, that is a follow link. Quite clearly, as a human, I can follow that link. But more specifically, Google can follow that link. So what I want to do is maybe edit this in some way so it's a nofollow link. How do I do that? Well, it couldn't really be easier. Because I'm using WordPress, what I want to do is install a plugin. So if I go to where it says plugins, add new, all I have to do is to go over here to search for a plugin. I think it's called Ultimate Nofollow. And there we are, we've got Ultimate Nofollow. It's not actually been tested with the latest version in this case, but I happen to know it works just fine, so I'll go and install this. Incidentally, if you're going to install this, back up your system prior to installing it, just in case. So there you are, I've installed it, I'll now activate it. Right, now I've installed the Ultimate Nofollow plugin, I can go back to my pages, and I could bring up that link, and if I click within that link, and then go to where it says Edit, and then click Link Options. Can you see here, if you're used to using WordPress, you may be familiar with this item here that says open the link in a new tab. But what that plugin did was allow me to click here to add a rel equals nofollow to that link. And if I click on Add Link and just confirm all that, that is now a nofollow link. Let's go and look at the code. There's two tabs here, visual and text. If I go to where it says text, can you see here? There's an extra little piece of code that's been inserted. That's all that plugin did. If you're more confident with using HTML, you could have gone in directly and edited that. But I've been using HTML for years and I still use the plugin. It just makes life easier. Again, that's why I love WordPress. Everything is easy in WordPress. So as you can see, there's the standard link there and what have you. There's what's called the anchor text. And there's the rel equals nofollow. So even though, let's update this. Let's view the page. So even though I can click on this, and it works just like it did before, so there's no problem with humans. It just means that Google will not follow the link. Now, Google have admitted, actually, in some cases, they will follow the link, but the important thing to realize from an SEO point of view is that in this case, this website here has a certain amount of trust and value and authority, and because this link is a nofollow link, it means that the trust and authority that's sort of bound up in this website will not be transferred to the other website when you click on this. So if I click on that, it means this website, you know, people can see it, but none of the goodness associated with the original website will be transferred to that second website. And that's really what follow and nofollow is all about. So remember, by default, all links are follow. If you want to, you can make outgoing links nofollow, and there are good reasons for doing this, because lots of it, good incoming relevant links to your website means that your site builds up authority. It's gaining what's called link juice. And the more links you have flowing away from your website means that that link juice is going to flow to other websites away from your site. So that's really the way you want to think about it. Don't necessarily make all outgoing links nofollow, but certainly if you're linking to, say, a low value page, then I would certainly put a nofollow on that.